Suppose there are infinite number of parallel lines which are at a distance of L from each other. We have a needle of length T and have to drop it randomly somewhere on the floor. After dropping the needle, it may or may not intersect with any line on the floor. We have to find the probability of its intersection with any line. This problem is known as Buffon's needle problem. You are watching Brain Explorers, the world where brain starts working. We are launching our new channel, Plan B. On Plan B, we will explain all topics in our mother tongue, Hindi. So if you understand Hindi, please go and subscribe now. Link is in the description. There will be no changes in Brain Explorers. Let's start with some basic probability problems. There are 10 boxes and a ball. We have to drop the ball randomly in any one of the box. Find the probability that ball will be dropped in the first box. Since there are 10 boxes, therefore number of elements in sample space are 10. Ball can go in the first box or seventh box or fourth box, etc. But only first box will be counted as favorable event. So probability is equal to number of favorable events over total number of events, which is equal to 1 over 10. Here is another example. Draw a line and make intervals of 1 cm on it. Change the color of alternate intervals to red. We have a dot which is shown with some diameter, but consider it as a point only. We have to put this point randomly on this line. Find the probability that this dot will lie on any red portion. This time, the length of sample space is infinite, and if we combine this red line, then also the length becomes infinite. It is a case of infinite over infinite. Here, we don't have to consider the whole number line. You can see that there is a repeating pattern, red after black and black after red. So take any one part of this repeating pattern and solve this problem. In this pattern, length of sample space is 2 cm. This point can lie on red as well as black. Lengths of both are 1 cm, so probability becomes 1 over 2. If length of red part is something else, for example 0.5 cm, then the probability becomes 0.5 cm over 2 cm, that is 1 over 4. There is one more example. Take a line segment of length B. Draw a line segment on it having a length of a cm. Problem is same as previous, but there is a little difference. Here we have a small line segment in place of a point. We have to put this smaller line segment on the line segment of length B. Find the probability that this segment will lie on this red portion. To solve this problem, do not look at the whole line segment. Just focus on one of its endpoints. This endpoint cannot go towards left, otherwise the line segment will get out of the larger line segment. But it can go towards right. So the length of sample space becomes b minus t centimeters. Now, to find the probability that this black segment lies either completely or partially on the red segment, favorable region becomes a centimeter, and if we have to find the probability that this line segment completely lies on the red part, the favorable region becomes a minus t centimeters. So for two different problems, two different answers are written here. Let's move slightly towards Buffon's needle problem. We will start with some special and simple case. Suppose rotation is not allowed and the needle always falls strictly vertical, that is always perpendicular to these lines. Consider only one end of the needle. Distances between parallel lines is L and the length of needle is T. Here also a pattern is repeating. So we can solve this problem by selecting the region between any two parallel lines. You can see that for a certain distance of the endpoint, needle is not intersecting with any line. This length is L minus T. If this point goes above this limit, the needle will definitely intersect. So, the favorable length is T. We get probability of intersection equals to T over L. If length of needle is more than the distance between parallel lines and rest of the conditions are same, then the needle will always be in the position of intersection, so the probability becomes 1. If needle is not vertical and is making certain angle with the horizontal, then we can solve this problem by making a right angle triangle using the horizontal and vertical lengths. In this triangle, hypotenuse and perpendicular either both are intersecting or both are not. Hence, we can solve this problem as previous problem by considering T sin theta as the length of a vertical straight needle. For L minus T sin theta distance, needle is not intersecting and for remaining length, it is intersecting. Here also, if T sin theta is greater than L, then the probability is 1. Now, come to general problem as described in the starting of the video. We will solve one by one for two cases, T less than L and greater than L. Draw a graph of T sin theta versus theta from 0 to pi by 2. When theta is pi by 2, it means needle is vertical. Remember that when needle was vertical, endpoint was intersecting for T distance and not intersecting for L minus T distance. If theta acquired any other value, say theta 1, there is T sin theta 1 distance in which if endpoint lies, needle intersects. This is true for other values of theta also. In this graph, every point is presenting a combination of angle and distance of needle with respect to a parallel line. Condition of the points which are in this blue region are favorable and rest are unfavorable. Probability of intersection becomes blue area over total area, that is 2t over pi l. If t is greater than l, then for smaller values of theta, needle does not intersect, but after a particular value alpha, needle certainly intersects. Sine of this angle is L over T. In the case of longer needle also, we have to make the same graph and after alpha, length of favorable region is L at every point. Rest of the process is same. Required probability is equal to blue area over total area. On calculation, we find it equals to 2t over pi l times 1 minus root 1 minus l square over t square plus 2 over pi times cos inverse l over t. There are the two answers for two different cases. Don't forget to like and share our video, and for more such videos, subscribe to our channel Brain Explorers. Thanks for watching.